Hey guys, my name is Suna and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be sharing with you guys which is my favorite place to be ordering takeout from. So I live in the city right next to Seoul to the east called Hanam, and it is a franchise, but there aren't any places close enough to where I live, so they don't deliver here. I really wish they would deliver, but they don't. So I'm going to have to go get it myself. So I'm gonna go there and then I'll just bring it back because I don't want to eat at the restaurant, you know, COVID and stuff. So I rather be on the safer side. So I'll just go buy it and then I'll come here and I'll show you guys what I get. I'm so freaking excited. I think the last time I had it was like 2 or 3 weeks ago. So it has been a while and I'm really excited to eat it. Like, I'm already hungry just thinking about it. So without further ado, let's go get my takeout. It is pretty cold outside, so I just threw on my long black puffer jacket, and this is like the warmest jacket I own. I'm just really excited to leave the house today because it is pretty late. It's almost 4 and I haven't left the house in the whole day. So I'm actually excited to go walk around a little bit, you know, just breathe in some fresh air. So I'll just show you guys a little bit of that in a little bit. I'm finally back home and this is the beautiful box it comes in. So when we open it, this is what it looks like. Oh my goodness, looks so good. Look at those fries. I haven't had fries in a while, and this is the beautiful Jamaican chicken. There's just like something about this that hits different, and I'm literally so hungry right now. So I'm gonna try the fries first. And the chicken, oh, I've been like literally looking forward to this for so long. I don't really know how they do it and like what they put in it, but it's just called the Jamaican chicken. It's kind of spicy in a very good way, so it just has this like extra flavor, and I just really like it. It's just so good. And this was maybe like $7, $8 ish. And I lived in Latin America, especially in Costa Rica, for a very, very long time. And since I don't really have that kind of food anymore that much, whenever I have this, for some reason, it kind of reminds me of some kind of food I used to have when we went to the Caribbean or something like that. So I really like it. I mean, I guess that's why it's called a Jamaican chicken. So I'm just going to enjoy this and I'll talk to you guys after the meal. Hey guys, so it's the next day and I had an amazing dinner last night because, as I told you guys, I just love that Jamaican chicken, and I feel like I've said that a lot in this vlog already. Oh, hey there. Look at her. So I'm going to be completely honest with you guys. I haven't mentioned this on this channel or anywhere, so you guys seeing this will be the first ones to know. So I am looking into changing my workplace. I'm not going to talk in detail about like all the things that led to it, but it was a very hard decision because I've never actually had to do this. Like, the only other time I had to like quit a job, it was because I'm trying to talk about serious matters and she just went into my drawer. So anyway, I'm sorry about that. I had to get her out of the drawer. Like, she went into the back part of it and I was trying to talk about serious things. So yeah, as I was saying, the only time I had to say I was gonna quit a job was back when I was in Costa Rica and I was coming to Korea. So I've been looking into a different job. I actually went to a job interview last week and then the academy thing happened that they all had to shut down. So I didn't get a call back from there, but I just got another call from a different academy, and luckily it's around my house. I have no idea how things will go, but wish me luck, finger crossed, we'll just go see how that goes. It's about 5:15 right now, so I should be leaving right now. I'm supposed to be there by 6, but I want to be there early, so I'm gonna go do that and I'll talk to you guys later. I just came back from the job interview, and the reason I'm telling you guys is because I wanted to be real with you guys, and if you guys are going through something similar, you guys know you're not the only ones. The interview actually went really, really well. It is in another English academy, but it's very, very different from the one I used to work in. So I do have a week of training period because I have to learn the system and everything. And it sounds like a fun challenge. So I'm gonna be starting next Monday and I'm really, really, really excited for that. And yeah, that was kind of a nerve-wracking moment. Like, I feel like job interviews are one of the most nerve-wracking moments of my life. I haven't gone to a lot, but like overall, they're just pretty nerve-wracking, yeah. So I went to Taizo on my way home, and I mean, I already had these Christmas bags. These are my parents' presents, but I decided to wrap them as well. So I got this. This was only $1 at Taizo. And I mean, it's not like the prettiest wrapping paper, but this is what they had. It was this one or another one, but I thought this was the better out of the two. Wait a minute, what is this? No, this is clear. This is not what I had in mind. What the fuck? I don't want to show you guys what presents I got them because they watch my vlogs and I don't want them to know before Christmas what they do with this. This is a stupid mistake. Oh my god. So I bought it, I'll just wrap it. So I brought my scissors and I have some tape over here. Yeah, I'll just wrap them because why not? So anyway, I'm not gonna show you guys what I got my parents, but this is what my dad's box looks like. Nothing to give it away. Puppy what? So I'm gonna start wrapping this up and I'll talk to you guys in a little bit. So I think I'm done and I think I did a pretty good job. Like, if I show you guys like my dad's present, for example, like it looks even like this. So I think it's really hard to tell what it actually is because I'm covering most of the images. And this is like another one. This is for a friend. And yeah, I think I did a pretty good job. Like, I made the best out of a really bad thing. I mean, I think it's decent. So I think all my presents for now I'll wrap up. That's really good. I still have some of these tissue paper that I still want to use for my friend's present, and Poppy's playing with it. So I'm just gonna put it back in the bag. And I have a little unboxing to do, so let's do that. So I have a very big box over here. Kind of heavy. It's nothing like impressive or anything, if you guys are thinking that. I think it's going to be beautiful. I hope so. At least in the pictures, this was like beautiful. Since I'm an adult, I need to start worrying about this stuff. It's beautiful. Oh my gosh. So I got a pan and pot set because I'm an independent woman and I need to kind of stuff in my house. But you guys just wait to see what kind I got. It says the brand is Neo Flam and it's like a retro edition. That's what the line is called. Oh, I mean, you guys can see there's like a blue and the white one, but mine is not blue nor white. Mine is actually... Guys, this has been my dream since I was little, like having my own pink pan and pot set. So pretty. Like, the inside is like this beige creamy color, the handle is like wooden beige color, and look at the pink. Oh my gosh, I'm obsessed. Wow, this is kind of heavy though. It also comes with this. This is the pot it comes with. Oh my gosh. And this is the lid. Oh my god, just tell me this is not the most beautiful pot. And there's one more. This is like actually gorgeous. I love it. And this is the other pot. So I have the pan, the regular pot, and this pot with the long handle. And they're all so pretty. I want to put them on my induction and see how they look. Guys, just look how gorgeous they look. I'm obsessed. Like, they even kind of match my blender. Oh my gosh. Yes, Poppy, I'm excited too. Wow, they look gorgeous. Like wow, they're so pretty. This makes me want to cook and I rarely ever cook. But yeah, maybe I'll start making some cooking videos or stuff for you guys. So it's about 8:55 right now and I'm just going to sit down on my computer and do some editing. I have my computer right now over here. And when I went to the Taizo earlier, I bought this little bag of Skittles, the sour ones. And these were one of my favorites back when I was in Costa Rica. So I really want to try it and see if it tastes the same, and I'm so excited. Just, like, I love the Skittles. Although they don't look like the same sour one. I have to say that I'm very disappointed at these. So the sour Skittles we had in Costa Rica, I guess they imported them from the United States, so I'm guessing it should be the same. But if you guys know, those ones have like a coating of the sour thing, and you can see the sour thing over there, and it's like literally so sour. And if that sour level was like 10 out of 10, this is like a 1. Like, this is for babies. This is not sour. Like, I'm literally so disappointed. Like, I was expecting sour Skittles, and this is just not it. I'm so disappointed. Like, I'm still gonna have them, but they just taste like normal Skittles with like 1% extra sourness. But anyway, all I'm going to do for the rest of the night is edit, and there's Poppy, as you guys can see. I'm going to end the vlog right here. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments down below any video ideas you guys have. And also, if you guys have questions you want to ask me, because I really want to do a Q&A, please let me know in the comments down below. And remember to follow me on my new Instagram account that I'll be leaving over here. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys really soon on my next video. Bye!